Hello, my name is Panagiotis Sidiropoulos, and I'm going to talk to you about our work on co-registration of NASA Mars Orbiter images to HRSC baseline. The motivation for our work is that the high-resolution orbital images of Mars are misaligned, as you, most of you already know, due to, for example, spacecraft pointing errors. Moreover, when we tried co-registration results from single instrument pairs of images, we can see that there are a lot of changes taking place on the Martian surface. So what we would need to do is to use multi-instrument co-registration results in order to exploit as much as possible the current data set. So we have built a pipeline that co-registers all high-resolution orbital images to a common baseline, and we used as a baseline the HRSC ORIS and DTMs. We used HRSC because this is the highest spatial resolution DTMs and ORIS, and they are co-registered to MOLA. So in this talk, I'm going to give you 9 CTX to HRSC examples, pairs of images. The CTX are co-registered to HRSC. The examples, each example is, the image area is 9 kilometers to 7 kilometers, and the HRSC images are downloaded from PSA and the CTX from PDS. And before showing you the examples, just as a conclusion, we can see that there are a lot of dynamic phenomena taking place on Mars. Most of these cases were selected randomly just to see how much changes we will find just selecting randomly CTX and HRSC image, and we have found a lot of changes. So in the future, we're going to do that in a more systematic way, and we're going to co-register all NASA, as possible NASA images to HRSC. So, no, don't do that. This is the detail of MERB. This is the HRSC images from 2004, and this is the same image. No, why this? Okay. So, and this is the same area from CTX from 6 years later. I don't know why he does that. Anyway, I don't know why it does that. Now it goes back and forth. This is an example from HRSC to CTX. The HRSC is 25 meters per pixel, while the CTX is 5.2 meters per pixel. So we can see that it's a large resolution difference. And even though the co-registration is rather good, this is the same thing. In this case, 25 meters to 5.2 meters. This is another example, HRSC to CTX. We have some residuals here. Still, the pipeline is not ready to do the whole work. It's going to be finalized the next month and going to do the actual processing in the next months. This is the example that Peter showed yesterday. Somewhere around here, you can see the most prominent result from a slope strake. This is another example, HRSC to CTX. In this case, we have slope strakes that are fading between HRSC and CTX, between 2005 and 2009. This is a crater. You can see also some strakes between 2005 and 2009. And this is the largest one since this some kilometers long. And this is some wind patterns that you can see from the two images. That was all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.